Morning students. So the next part of ionic equilibrium will continue. See,
hydrogen ion concentration is H plus,
square bracket indicates molar concentration.
Hydrogen ion concentration in the acidic solutions. Similarly, hydroxyl ion concentrations is OH minus in the basic solution. Similarly, dissociation constant, for weak acid and dissociation constant for weak base. So these two things we shall try to understand today. Hydrogen ion concentration for any strong acid, for example 0.1 mM HCl. See, in the aqueous solution, it ionizes completely into ions, that is H3O plus Cl minus. So, what is hydrogen ion concentration? Here you have to understand H3O plus is the same as H plus. Because hydrogen ion gets hydrated, yesterday I told you, to form hydronium ion in the aqueous solution. There is plenty of water here and it is a solvent, excess. Or you can also write it this way, HCl gives H plus Cl minus. Whatever is the concentration of hydrochloric acid, same thing is the concentration of hydrogen ion, even chloride ion also same. Or you can say, in general, monobasic acid, consider monobasic acid, basicity 1, monobasic acid, like in a HA plus H2O gives H plus H3O plus A minus. Suppose if this is a strong acid, hydrogen ion concentration is directly calculated by knowing the concentration of the acid. One of the examples I will show you. HCl I already told you. Suppose we take H2SO4, maybe 0.05. So this is also a strong acid. You see, it ionizes to 2H+. So that is why, what is the hydrogen ion concentration? 2 into 10 to 0.05. 0.05, 5 into 10 raised to minus 2. Or you can write like that only, 0.05. So hydrogen ion concentration is, total hydrogen ion concentration is 0.1. So acid is 0.05, hydrogen ion concentration is 0.1. So directly calculated. Similarly, hydroxyl ion concentration for strong bases, for example NaOH, M by 100, Na plus plus AQ, right? OH minus M by 100. So it is monobasic. So this is also M by 100. And M by 100 means 0.01 mM. So by knowing the concentration of the strong base, you can calculate directly hydroxyl ion concentration. Suppose if it is a barium hydroxide,
which is considered as a strong base, dissociates completely. Suppose if this is 0.02 m, 2 into 0.02, right? What is the hydroxylase concentration? In barium hydroxide, 0.04 m. So for strong acid, strong base, directly hydrogen ion or hydroxyl ion concentration is calculated. So here you can write directly calculated. Okay, here also same. Hydroxyl ion concentration for strong bases directly calculated. Understand? If I give you the acid concentration, strong acid, you will find its hydrogen ion concentration. If I give you the strong base concentration, you will find hydroxyl ion concentration. So this is one point very, very clear. Now this is a very important one. Consider a weak monobasic acid. Weak monobasic acid. Like acetic acid. HA H3O plus A minus. Here, this is, suppose if this is 0.1 m, this is not 0.1 m, understand? Because it will not ionize completely. What is weak acid or weak base which does not ionize completely into ions? Partially ionizes into ions. 1%, 2% or even less than that. Molecular form, unionized form is plenty in the aqueous solution. Then there exists an equilibrium like this. So how to calculate the equilibrium constant? So initial I will take C moles and nothing is dissociated. Think. C mole stands for undissociated form. Now think, if alpha is degree of dissociation, see, at equilibrium, the fraction which dissociates from one mole. I write a note here. What is degree of dissociation? The fraction which dissociates from one mole is called degree of dissociation. Okay, it's called degree of dissociation. Now you say, suppose if alpha is the degree of dissociation, for 1 mole alpha, for C mole, C alpha dissociates, right answer. If it is 2 mole, 2 alpha goes. If it is 1 mole, only alpha goes. Now 1 mole gives 1 mole. That is why this is excess, its concentration is taken as unit. Now C alpha, A minus is also C alpha, H3O plus is also C alpha. Now the equilibrium constant is written with a different word, the dissociation constant. Nothing but equilibrium constant. The dissociation constant, KA, A stands for acid. Because this is a weak acid. Ions, numerator first and product in the numerator, H3O plus A minus divided by HA concentration of undissociated acid. You substitute the values at equilibrium. C alpha divided C minus C alpha. So C square alpha square divided by C comma 1 minus alpha. So once it gets cancelled, KA equal to alpha square C by 1 minus alpha. So alpha square C by 1 minus alpha remains constant, and that constant is called what? Dissociation constant of weak acid. Understand? Suppose if the value of dissociation constant is more, numerator is more. That means ions are more. One example I give. HCOOH, formic acid. CH3COOH, acetic acid. Both are weak acids. K, 1.74 into 10 raised to minus 4. K, 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. Almost 10 times more. Minus 4 is 10 times more. So that means this acid is 10 times stronger than this acid. Because numerator is more. So, higher the Ka value among weak acids, stronger is the acids. For weak acids, Ka less than 1. Ka less than 1 implies weak acids. So, what is Ka? Dissociation constant of weak acids. Some more things you can do here. I will call this as equation 1. Here some of the things are there. Hydrogen ion concentration H3O plus. You can call it as C alpha. Do you agree? H3O plus concentration is C alpha. Therefore, what is alpha? Alpha is hydrogen ion concentration divided by C, is it not? Now, from equation 1, since the acid is weak, 1 minus alpha can be almost equated to 1 because alpha is neglected. Alpha is neglected. Suppose if you neglect alpha compared to 1, then K equal to what will happen? I start from here, H plus concentration. C alpha is H plus concentration. H plus concentration whole square. Look here, C alpha, divided by denominator, I will write C into 1 minus alpha. C I have taken common. And now this becomes K equal to H plus square divided by C. Or if I write H plus equal to H plus or H3O plus, one and same. Square H3O plus square. Suppose if I take H3O plus hydronium ion concentration, cross multiply K into C, square root of K into C. This can be used to calculate H3O plus is square root of K into C. So some of the important things here, degree of dissociation you can calculate by this formula. Hydrogen ion concentration you can calculate by this formula. Dissociation constant you can calculate by this formula or by knowing initial concentration and hydrogen ion concentration. Now same thing I will tell you for weak bases here. For strong bases, I have told you. So once again, I don't derive. I write the direct expressions. Tell me, for weak bases, what will happen now? for weak bases like this. Dissociation constant. Dissociation constant Kb. So Kb equal to same alpha square C by 1 minus alpha. This is one formula. And what is OH minus concentration? This is C alpha. Then what is alpha degree of dissociation? OH minus concentration divided by C initial concentration. And lastly, what is OH minus concentration in terms of the dissociation constant? Same thing. Root Kb into C. Do you agree? Same thing. Because derivation is there on the other side of the board. So by making use of these formulas, not these formulas, you can work out hydrogen ion concentration in weak acids, hydroxyl ion concentration in weak bases, dissociation constant of weak acid, dissociation constant of weak base, degree of dissociation in weak acid, degree of dissociation in weak base. One important note I will give you. Look here. For conjugate acid base pair, what I told is stronger the acid, weaker is the conjugate base. Or weaker the acid, stronger is the conjugate base. Suppose if you take Ka as the dissociation constant for conjugate acid, Kb will be dissociation constant for its conjugate base. So this is the importance. Ka into Kb equal to 10 raised to minus 40. How this comes, I will show you little later. Because what is 10 raised to minus 40? And that is nothing but Ka into Kb equal to Kd. And this is ionic product. What? Ka into Kb. So time being, we note this. I'll come to this Kw, ionic product of water. Now it's okay. So whatever is on the board, I will once again clarify. Now we have learned for strong acids, strong bases, hydrogen ion concentration or hydroxyl ion concentration is directly calculated because it ionizes 100%. For weak acids and weak bases, this is the way I have shown you. We have to derive it by understanding, by knowing the degree of dissociation. Is it okay? So note all the things and I will continue with another important point that is called ionic product of water. The next heading, ionic product of water. Kw. What is the notation? Kw. So what is ionic product of water? At 298 Kelvin temperature, in any aqueous solution, look here. So far, what is the understanding? I'll tell you. You are all thinking that in any acids there is hydrogen ion concentration, and in any base there is hydroxyl ion concentration. which is not exactly true. Now I will correct it and tell you. Look here. In any aqueous solution, there is both hydrogen ion concentration as well as hydroxyl ion concentration. However, in acidic solution, hydrogen ion concentration is more than hydroxyl ion concentration. In basic solution, hydrogen ion concentration is less than hydroxyl ion concentration. In neutral solution, hydrogen ion concentration is equal to hydroxyl. In 0.01 mHg4 sulfuric acid, there is hydroxyl ion concentration. Hydrogen ion concentration is there, you know, there is hydroxyl ion concentration. I will calculate, I will show you. So, what is ionic product of water? At 298 Kelvin temperature in any aqueous solution, the product of hydrogen ion concentration and hydroxyl ion concentration is constant and it is equal to 10⁻⁴. And this is any product of water. I'll get an expression. Look. H2O gives H plus OH minus. Or if you want, you can write in this H3O plus OH minus. Since one of the water is in the solvent and it is excess. The ionic product of water, dissociation constant itself is ionic product of water. Okay, you must write KW equal to H3O plus concentration, OH minus concentration divided by H2O. This is excess, is it not? Right, understand? Try to understand. In 1 liter water, maybe 1000 divided by 18 molar mass, mass by molar mass, 55.55. So water concentration is 55.55 m mole per liter. But you know what is hydrogen ion concentration? H3O plus is so less in water. It is pure water I am talking. 10 raised to minus 7. 0.12345671 m. So less. Hydroxyl ion concentration? Same. 10 raised to minus 7 m. That is why. What is the product now? H3O plus into OH minus is 10 raised to minus 14. And denominator we have neglected because it is so high compared to the hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion. So we have neglected the numerator, denominator, and called as ionic product of water. It's nothing but equilibrium constant. So by convention, anything which is in excess, the concentration is taken as unit. This is by convention. One. Now what is the conclusion? Mathematically, how do we write? At 298 Kelvin, H plus concentration, substance concentration 10^-14. Or this is also you can write as H3O plus concentration into OH minus concentration 10^-14. So in any aqueous solution, product of hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion concentration is constant. Understood? What is the definition of ionic product of water? Then elaborate one. In acidic solution, what will happen? In acidic solution, H3O plus is more than OH. In basic solution, what will happen? H3O plus is less than OH minus. In neutral solution, what will happen? In neutral solution, H3O plus is same as OH minus. And each is 10^-7 m. This also you should know. In neutral solution, also and what? And in neutral solution and pure water. No. Pure water. Because hydrogen and hydroxyl ion concentrations are equal. And this is 10^-7. So one simple problem can be worked out here. See this. Find hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion concentration of 0.02 m H2SO4. H2SO4 sulfuric acid, strong electrolyte, 2H plus SO4 2 minus. So this is 0.02 m. So 2 × 0.02, we are in because it is strong electrolyte. H plus is 0.04 m or 4 × 10^-2 m. Then H plus into OH minus. This is 10^-14. So if you want OH minus, 10^-14 divided by H plus. 10^-14 divided by 4 × 10^-2. So 1 by 4, you can write it as 0.25 into 10^-12. This is 12 here. So less, minus 12. 2 sign conversion. 2.5 into 10^-13. So 10^-13 m is so less, is it not? So in sulfuric acid, how many zeros? How many zeros? I think, how many zeros? 12 zeros. That much less it is. 0.0000. So much less. But it is there. This is the meaning. So in any aqueous solution, both hydrogen and hydroxyl ion exist. That is the meaning of what? Ionic product. Water. Notice. What is the value of ionic product of water at 298 Kelvin? It is 10^-14. But one important thing is that it depends on temperature. At 100 degree Celsius, in pure water, notice, in pure water, H3O plus concentration into OH minus concentration, 10^-12 m, notice, 12. 10^-12. It means 100 times ionization is more in pure water. At 100. That means temperature you have to tell. 298 Kelvin is nothing but 25 degree. So it is must to give the temperature. 298 Kelvin, thermodynamic standard temperature. Not this. So now understood? Another thing I made clear now. In any aqueous solution, both hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion concentration exists. So please note these points also. Now the most important aspect I discussed. pH. How to determine the strength of acid and strength of base. So please note this. values. pH values in the notation. See, a French chemist, Sorensen, French chemist, he found a scale to determine the strength of a given fluid, whether acidic or basic or neutral, to what extent. And that is measured in terms of its pH value. The scale, pH scale, starts from 0 and it has got values up to 14. And you know, 7 is the center point. Now, what is the understanding is, any liquid at 0 pH is the highest acidic. As and when it starts moving from 1, 2, 3, like that, each 1 unit increase, 10 times the acidic strength decreases. So I'll start with strongest acid, 10 times less, 100 times less compared to this, 1000 times less. Decreases acidic strength, neutral. Basic strength increases, 8, increase, 9, more basic, highest basic, that is 14. This is acidic, this is basic, and exactly 7, this is neutral. So in neutral solution, what is the pH? It is exactly 7. And again it is at what temperature? 298 Kelvin. Then what is the definition of pH? What is the definition of pH? See, pH is defined as negative logarithm. pH is defined as negative logarithm of molar hydrogen ion concentration to the base 10. Understand? pH is negative logarithm of molar hydrogen ion concentration, or hydronium ion, same I told you, to the base 10. This is the definition of pH. Now you can understand. I work out for some of the HCl, 2 HCl I did. This is 1 m. This is 0.1 m, 10 times weaker. 0.01 m, this is 100 times weaker compared to this. Because 10 times you added water, and again 10 times you added water, get this. Now, according to the definition, pH equal to negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration to the base 10, negative logarithm of 1, and log 1 is 0. Log 1 is 0 to the base 10. pH equal to negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration to the base 10, negative logarithm of 0.1, 10 raised to minus 1. Do you agree? 0.1 is 10 raised to minus 1. Logarithmic rule is there. Log m raised to n is n log m. Minus of minus 1 log 10. Not this point. Log 10 is 1. Total it is plus 1. Log 10 is 1. Log m raised to n is n log m. I told you all these things. So pH equal to negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration to the base 10, negative logarithm of 10 raised to minus 2, do you agree? 0.01 to the base 10. So minus of minus 2 log 10, correct? Log 10 is 1, this is plus 2. Now what is happening? 10 times, compare this 10 times. So 1, 2, 0, pH 0, pH 1, pH 2. I think you understood. By definition only it is coming like this. As and when hydrogen ion concentration decreases 10 times, pH increases by 1 unit. Now calculate. Is it okay? Then, how about hydroxyl ion concentration? POH value. POH is same. POH is equal to negative logarithm of OH minus concentration. You understand?
In sodium hydroxide solution,
you can calculate OH minus concentration. By which you can get POH. Then how to calculate pH?
And one very, very important formula. Show that pH plus POH equal to 14 and 298 Kelvin. So this will give you how to calculate pH. If you know pH, you can find POH. If you know POH for bases, you can also find pH. This is very simple derivation. At 298 Kelvin, by ionic product of water. What is ionic product of water? Just now we have derived H plus into OH minus. I will express only, it's not H2 plus. It is easy, you know. 10 raised to minus 14, correct? Taking negative logarithm on both sides. Minus log of H plus concentration into OH minus concentration equal to minus log of 10 raised to minus 14. So minus log of H plus log M into minus log of OH minus. Then we will open to that. Minus of minus 14 log 10. Minus log H plus is for pH. Minus log OH minus is for POH. This is log 10 is 1, 14. So it means pH plus POH equal to 14. Yes or no? Okay. In pure water or neutral solution, H plus concentration 10 raised to minus 7 implies pH is 7. OH minus concentration 10 raised to minus 7 implies POH is also 7. So pH plus POH is again 14. Some one or two problems you can work out here. Find pH of 0.02 HCl. HCl gives H plus Cl minus. It means H plus concentration is 0.02 2 into 10 raised to minus 2 pH equal to negative logarithm of 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. Yes or no? So open the bracket. Negative logarithm of 2 plus 2 log 10. I have shown you. Minus of minus. Minus, one place is there, 0.3010 plus 2 into 1, 2. Minus 0.3010 plus 2. 1.6990. This is pH. One homework will write. Find pH of 0.02 barium hydroxide assuming complete ionization. So what to do? You have to first find POH. POH
negative logarithm of OH minus concentration to the base 10. Where am I talking? Double. So it is minus log of 0.004. It's not 0.04. So minus log of 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. This is pure H. You can continue. Last thing, once you get the value, pH plus pOH equal to 14, by which you get pH. Suppose, if the question is asked for a weak acid, actually, practicals are there. Universal indicator tells you pH. pH papers are there. So many solutions you have whose pH you don't know. Add 1111 drop of universal indicator. On the bottle there is a color distinguishing from 0 to 14. Red to dark blue, white. So you compare the color developed in this with the color on the universal indicator bottle. Or pH papers are there, standard paper is there. pH 1 this color, pH 7 green color, pH 14 violet color, pH 1 red color, like this. Now dip the paper, compare the color with this standard. Patches are there, color patches on the paper. This color gives this pH on the end. So ordinary paper dipped in universal indicator, adhke pH paper enter. So that is dipped in solution. You see the color. Compare it with the standard paper. For example, suppose some leaflets are there. Some leaflets are there on both sides. Dead ends of that leaflets. Standard papers are there with one. This is not one to dip. It is to just see the color comparison. Inner side papers you have to remove and dip it. That is the way I think you have got practicals to do. You have seen it. That is how you can understand pH. One problem we will look at. Find pH and pOH of 0.05 m acetic acid or 0.02 m acetic acid at 298 Kelvin given Ka 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5 at 298 Kelvin. Dissociation constant is given. Okay, I have got a formula. H plus concentration or H3O plus concentration square root of Ka into C. Yes or no? For weak acid. That is square root of 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5 into 0.02. I will make it 18 into 10 raised to minus 6. Okay. 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. I think you understood. 36 and then third water into 10 raised to minus 8. You remove outside 6 into 10 raised to minus 4 m. I got hydrogen ion concentration. pH equal to negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration to the base 10. Negative logarithm of 6 into 10 raised to minus 4. Minus log 6 to the base 10 plus 4 log 10. I think you understood. So far I have been doing the same. Minus 0.2 log 6. I think log 5 is 0.6990. 7.8. 0.78 plus 4. 3.2. If you want P, but pH plus pOH? pH plus pOH. pH plus pOH equal to 14. So pOH is 14 minus pH. 14 minus 3.22, it becomes 7.8. This is pure H. Even if it is asked for weak acid or weak base, you can also work out. See, pH is one of the very important thing to understand. See, it is having a lot of practical application. For example, biological fluids, some of the biological fluids, pH actually. For example, gastric juice in the stomach, it is nearly 1.5 to 2 pH, highly acidic. Saliva in the mouth, this is 5.5 to 7 pH. Blood is slightly alkaline, 7.4 pH. Milk is slightly alkaline, now basic, 6.8 pH. For example, this lemon juice has high pH, nearly 2 to 2.3 range. That is why people having acidity at all, they should not drink lemon juice much. High acidity. Tomato juice, little higher pH. Lesser the pH, stronger is the acid. You know that. So these are pH of some of the milk of magnesia, pH 10, it is basic. It is used as antacid. Magnesium hydroxide. This is called milk of magnesia, nearly 10 pH. As the acidity is there in the stomach, tablets can be taken. So pH has got, see, our biological fluids or enzymes, etc., they function at definite pH. For example, in the mouth or in the stomach, it should be acidic pH. In the intestine, it should be intestinal juice has pH 7.8. That means it is basic pH. Intestinal juice, it is 7.8. That means, again, sodium carbonates are secreted and it becomes basic. So pH is one of the very, very important aspect. So whatever I have discussed today, the most important class I feel, and I think with this I can. Thank you.